Home Assistant 2022.9 is bringing some great new features, and I'll try to show you the most interesting ones in this video. If you have a hard time understanding some of the smart home words and abbreviations that I'm using, don't worry, I got you covered with my smart home glossary. You can download it absolutely for free from my website automatelike.pro/glossary. Now, without further ado, let's get started. The first new feature in Home Assistant 2022.9 is the weekly shadow helper. As you may already know, there is a helpers menu inside Home Assistant settings where you can create multiple helpers, including toggles, buttons, numbers, and many more. In this exact helpers menu, the shadow helper is now also available. Creating a weekly shadow helper is very easy and intuitive. You can set a name of your choice, you can select the MDA icon, and then you can drag your mouse over the time slots that you're interested. You can do that for every day of the week, but the real question is, what can I do next with that weekly shadow helper? The newly created schedule is now available as Home Assistant entity that have on or off state depending of your selection during the schedule creation. If for example you mark the slot from 9 to 10 a.m. in Tuesday and the current day and time is Tuesday 8:59 in the morning, the state of the schedule entity will be off. But during 9 a.m. and 10 a.m., the state will become on. So you can use that weekly schedule helper as Home Assistant automation trigger, and based on your custom schedule, you can start and stop things or send notifications or whatever you actually wish. And while I'm talking about Home Assistant automations, let's move to the next new feature in Home Assistant 2022.9, which is a new look of the Automation Editor. This is how the Automation Editor was looking before 2022.9, and this is how it looks like now. In essence, the process of creating automations is exactly the same. You have to set your triggers, optionally conditions, and to add one or more actions. The new editor is much more minimalistic and it has some new automatic naming of the automation parts that I really like. Of course, it is possible to rename them from the three dots menu. I have a quick challenge for you. Can you please watch this video till the very end and let me know in the comments which new Home Assistant 2022.9 feature is your favorite? I'll also share mine later. Next two things are not part of the Home Assistant 2022.9 release, but they are closely related and they are brand new, so I decided to share them with you. The first one is ESP Home Bluetooth proxies. If you go to this website with a Chrome or Edge browser and you have a spare ESP32 board, M5 stack Atom Lite, or Olimex ESP32 power over Ethernet device, you can install ESP Home on that device and start using it as Home Assistant Bluetooth proxy, expanding the Bluetooth coverage in your home. The other new thing is the BT Home, which is a new open standard for broadcasting sensor data over Bluetooth low energy. For now, BT Home is supported by Home Assistant, ATC Mi Thermometer, and B-Parasite sensors, but hopefully it will be embraced by many others soon, so the Bluetooth communication and integration with Home Assistant to become even easier and more reliable. Do you know that there are four official methods to get Home Assistant? I am discussing them in details in my free Home Assistant webinar. Along with the official methods in the webinar, I'm also sharing one not so popular but super simple way to start experimenting with Home Assistant in under 5 minutes. If you're interested, check it on my website automatelike.pro/webinar. As I said, it is completely free. Next new feature in Home Assistant 2022.9 is for the Z-Wave GS lovers. If your Z-Wave devices are in Home Assistant, have an update you will be notified and you will be able to update them right from the Home Assistant. Zigbee fans are not left behind in Home Assistant 2022.9. From now on, you can create a backup of your Zigbee devices and network, and you can restore that backup on a new Home Assistant device. Even Zigbee to MQTT is supported, which is really convenient. Next, if you press the C button while you are inside your Home Assistant and start typing hardware and then select Navigate Hardware, you see the new processor and memory usage section in Home Assistant 2022.9. This is very good and quick way to see how much your Home Assistant is loaded. I had a quick giveaway last week where you just had to subscribe and comment under my Shelly Plus HNT video to participate. Now, let's see who is going to win that giveaway, and the reward is one new Shelly Plus HNT sensor. I will use this website to help me pick the winner, and I'll paste my Shelly Plus HNT video URL here. I'll tick this filter duplicate users. I'll answer this captcha question and I'll click on get YouTube comments. I have 80 comments and then I'll click on this big start button. Wish you luck. And winner is Mark Kondik. I have multiple Zigbee smart temperature and humidity sensors in the living room, kitchen, bathroom and bedroom. The videos are very informative. Great! Congratulations, Mark! Contact me via email or Twitter and you receive your Shelly Plus HNT sensor directly to your door for free. My favorite Home Assistant 2022.9 feature is the weekly schedule helper. Please share what is yours in the comments. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!